Greetings, everyone, and welcome to the 5th Niue Arts and Cultural Festival.
It's the first time the biannual event has been held here on the Rock. The week-long celebrations were launched by Niue's recently knighted premier with the help of an iconic Niuean musician.
The theme for this year's festival is Oki Mua Moivanga Hau Niue, which means move forward with Niue language. And what better place to be inspired by this beautiful taonga than here in Niue?
With less than 15% of Niueans globally speaking their language, the festival has made it a focus.
It is a reminder for the young people to remember who they are, where they come from, and move forward is to speak the language. We have to. Otherwise, there'll be no Niue language in the world.
The more you use the language, the better it is. We shouldn't be treating it any different than any other language that we use. We make it accessible to our young ones in particular.
Vangahau got a chance to shine on the poetry stage thanks to many of the locals and those abroad through tales of love and laughter.
Welcome to our TAGATA PASIFIKA show for tonight.
But for one young New Zealand-based Niuean, his heartfelt spoken word was on behalf of many.
As a grown man born of Niue blood, like the ocean is to the Ika, I stand here ashamed, embarrassed and unworthy of such a paradise to call in my home. Because I don't speak Vangahau Niue.
Making the most of paradise is writer Zora Feilo, who waited nearly 2 years to bring her book of Niuean tales to the island nation.
The tales of Nikatu Taha, they're set here in Niue, in the different villages. So it was important for me to bring the book back home. It felt nice, it felt right. And even though we live in New Zealand, we still remember home. We never forget where we come from. So it's about roots and people you know.
Another highlight of the festival is a Niuean son who has returned home. Iconic Niuean artist John Pule has set up in his village of Liku, which has added a new element to his work.
I'm just trying to kind of do things that I haven't done before, like opening up my studio for the public, having an exhibition up in the Liku Hall with the community.
John has been an amazing Niue arts ambassador. He's been very passionate about promoting the arts and culture here in Niue, and of course he uses his different media platforms and his international travels to be able to do that, so that's been really great.
Throughout the week, a variety of different events were held. And even arts and crafts workshops and displays were held daily so that people could learn about culture at their leisure. Local band Island Pride launched their new album. It's been 10 years since their last offering, and this latest installation focuses on language.
Because the festival is very important for the Niueans coming back to Niue, we wanted to give them something Niuean-based. Hopefully, they'll have a little bit of connection with the Niuean language and want to come back to Niue.
Since musician Glenn Jackson has relocated back to the Rock, it's been a welcome move for his band.
Getting him back into the fold with all of us who live here was a really good thing for us. It was a good time that he came back to Niue. Like all the other guys, got to come back to Niue.
The fact that it fell in time with the festival, perfect time. All the stars lined up for it, so we're really happy to, that happened.
And it's Niue's laid-back lifestyle and environment that has inspired much of the production of the music.
Amatofa is my favourite track because it talks about the conservation of our whales, and we are surrounded by the moanans. So having that as part of the album, it's a good way to push that and promote our conservation of whales.
Crowd favourite is the fashion show, where Niueans here and abroad put their creative and natural flair on display.
Oh, what I liked about my outfits is that they're a lot more modern than how they used to be. Yeah, it's not all covered up like in the olden days. It's really good how they do it now. They make it nice and colourful, yeah, so it's a good combination.
Judging by all the different costumes here tonight, I think it'll be much, much better and different in the next few years to come.
Celebrating culture and heritage is why having the festival in place is important for all Niueans.
The objective of the festival is to bring together all the Niue people living in Niue and abroad, bridging the gap and building up our heritage.
This is a great way of teaching our young ones and also teaching Niueans living overseas, and a lot of them are quite interested in coming to Niue and learning about the culture and finding out about their families as well. So it's a win-win for all.
The beauty of Niue's people, land and heritage is something organisers will be keen to nurture for years to come.